I found one in the hymnal, strangely enough, that was really, really good. I liked the words. And if any of you know Spanish, you could actually open to 725 and sing it in Spanish. But if you don't know Spanish, maybe you can do the chorus. So the chorus is, "We see God here by our side, walking our way." When the poor ones who have nothing still are giving, when the thirsty pass the cup of water to share, when the wounded offer others strength and healing, we see God here by our side, walking our way. We see God here by our side, walking our way. When compassion gives us suffering consolation, when expecting brings to birth hope that is lost, when you choose love, not the hatred all around us, we see God here by our side, walking our way. We see God here by our side, walking our way. When our spirit, like a chalice brimmed with gladness, when our voices full and clear sing out the truth, when our longings free and thee seek the humble, we see God here by our side, walking our way. We see God here by our side, walking away. When the goodness poured from heaven fills our dwelling, when the nations work to change war into peace, when the stranger is accepted as our neighbor, we see God here by our side, walking our way. We see God here by our side, walking our way. I love that. And now I know a new song. All right, how about "Here I Am to Worship"?
Step down into darkness, open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above, you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became poor. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful. How much my sin upon that cross. You'll never know how much it cost to see my sin upon that cross. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Good evening. Welcome to St. Olaf. For anybody who doesn't know who I am, I'm Cindy Schlieve, one of the assisting ministers and lay preachers here at St. Olaf, and filling in for Pastor Tom this weekend. And he and I believe 12 youth and four, along with three other adults, are on their way to Nashville for the youth mission trip. So that's why they're not here. So we welcome all of you. I'll mention right now, Jane Christensen is in the hospital, and she's at Oconomowoc Memorial. She'll be there through Sunday, and then she'll be going to rehab. And I don't know how long that will be, but just if you would keep her in your prayers, and I believe Dave added her to the list, so we'll have her there. But, and any of you who do come to Searchers, remember then we are moving Searchers to here on Tuesday mornings until further notice. And there is no Searchers on July 4th because it falls on Tuesday. So there's no Searchers that day. But otherwise, we'll just keep Jane in our prayers. And she's doing pretty well. I got a chance to see her today. So she doesn't really like being there. But if she gets better, it's a good thing. So if you would all like to stand and go around and greet each other with shalom or in what other manner, that would be wonderful.
All right, we're going to try a song we've done before. Take My Life.
Stand or sit, whichever you're most comfortable with. I'll be sitting. We'll be sitting.
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to Thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow with ceaseless praise. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of Thy love. Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for Thee. Take my voice and let me sing, always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from Thee. Shake my silver and my gold, not of my wood I will hold. Take my intellect and use every power as you choose. Here am I, all of me. Take my life, it's all for Thee. Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart, it is thine own. It shall be thy royal throne. Take my love, my Lord, I pour. At your feet its treasure store. Take myself and I will be ever only all for thee. Of me. Take my life, it's all for thee.
Gracious and loving God, we are so blessed to have this time to pray, to worship, to hear your word. Each week, remembering the things with which we have been blessed is a really important and special part of our prayer lives. Our freedom to worship you and pray with each other is definitely one of our greatest blessings. Lord, as we think of our blessings, let us also think of those sins we have committed in the past week. Let us look into our hearts and minds and search for the honesty that you have requested of us and share those transgressions with you now in silence. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you. And for his sake, God forgives you all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives us the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated. I'm just going to move over a little bit and sit back down. Gospel according to Matthew chapter 25 verses 34 through 40. Glory to you, O Lord. Then the king will say to those on his right, come you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in? Or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? The king will reply, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did for me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. My eyes aren't good enough to do this without glasses anymore, even with a large font. Thankful hearts and voices raised, tell everyone what God has done. This is the opening line of the hymn, Thankful Hearts and Voices Raised. Words like that help me to remember that since we live in this beautiful lake country area, we have so much to be thankful for. For the most part, we have a place to live, food to eat that sustains us, clothes to wear, and most probably much, much more than we really need. So it is sad to know that there are people who struggle every single day to find food, to find a place to stay and be safe, to have clothes to wear, to be able to care for their families. When I think about Milwaukee and its surrounding area, as well as other large cities that are in the United States, I know that the struggle is real and so very difficult for those people. Today, I would like to share with you some information about a very important group that is working in and around Milwaukee. They are called the Street Angels. Now, tomorrow morning, I actually have two people coming that were instrumental in starting this group, but they couldn't come tonight, so I'm going to talk about them, and hopefully you'll be interested in what they do. But I also have some other thoughts to share with you tonight, too. But the final words of our gospel lesson today does say it all. I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these, brothers of mine, you did for me. Hearing those words just helps us to understand that God is cheering us on and pushing us forward to help others that are in need. That falls right in with John 15, verse 12, which reads, "This is my commandment, love each other just as I have loved you." And then there's Philippians chapter 2, verse 4, that reads, "Instead of each person watching out for their own good, watch out for what is better for others." Once again, we're told to go out and help others. Since one of St. Olaf's long-standing annual projects was just completed for 2023, I'd like to touch on that first. St. Benedict the Moor Parish, that's its official name, with leadership from the Capuchin Community Services, which is located on 6th and State Street in Milwaukee, has provided a meal for people in need since November 13th, 1970. They actually started out of someone's house. They partner with other churches and community groups to provide this meal from Sunday through Friday. St. Olaf has been the partner for this meal on the third Tuesday of June for many years now. Unfortunately, I don't know when we started, but it's been a long time. The meal we prepare, take to the site, and help serve consists of beef stew, a tossed lettuce salad, and homemade cookies. This year, I am pleased to say that the help this congregation provided in preparing the meal and providing the cookies was amazing. We served the meal this past Tuesday to 130 adults and one child. It was, as it always is, an amazing opportunity to offer our help to people in need. It did seem like some of the people who came to the meal were homeless, but not all, and maybe not even most. They were all very appreciative of the meal, and the Capuchin community brothers were very pleased with everything we were able to provide. As always, it was a wonderful experience and has to remind us that we must be thankful for everything we have in this life. I want to say also that the people are treated like family, and they are called guests. It is so very important that we treat everyone that we meet with respect and courtesy, no matter their circumstances or ours. Again, I thank everyone from St. Olaf or Friends of St. Olaf who helped us in this most important project. What a blessing you all are. And the picture, you can see the two of them. One is right outside the door, and you can only see part of the sign, but it says the loaves and fishes. And the other one was us with our lovely green aprons. We got compliments on our green aprons and serving the food down the line. So that's what those pictures are from. Two members of our congregation work closely with two different congregations in Milwaukee. Randy Sycamo works with Redeemer, and Steve Stretz works with All People's Church. They both have such an impact with their ministries, but I want to share a little bit about Randy's ministry at Redeemer. First, right now, Redeemer is offering lunch, usually soup and sandwiches, on Sundays at noon. Randy is the primary source for this food, though our own soup troop has helped provide soup once a month for them. There is such a history here, and I hope one day Randy can tell his whole story of this ministry. He gave me a long list of things, and I can't share all of them, but I would love him to share it with you sometime. The folks who come to the meals and other types of events offered at Redeemer are again treated like family, which helps them to want to move forward and improve their lives in whatever ways they can. Once again, the way the people are treated can go a long way toward helping them find a safer and better life. And now I would like to talk about the street angels. I first heard about them, actually, on the news when one of their vans was destroyed. That was maybe 2 years ago. Donations allowed them to replace that van. And the women of the ELCA for the Milwaukee Synod had one of the founders speak to us at our fall convention last October. It's hard to be brief about all of these wonderful ministries, but I'll try. Street Angels is a mobile outreach organization that uses a friends-first approach to respond to the needs of individuals experiencing unsheltered homelessness. So their focus is totally on homeless people. The Street Angels staff and volunteers are dedicated to assisting individuals in ending their homelessness by providing dignified services, advocacy, connections to critical resources, and hope. Street Angels was founded in 2016 by two women who began serving meals from the back of their cars. The organization has since grown to be a highly regarded leader in street outreach with two outreach buses and six staff members, three full-time, three part-time. Additionally, there are also over 8,000 volunteer hours provided to the organization annually, and the entire mission is privately funded through caring community members, philanthropic foundations, corporations, and local businesses. Every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday evenings, it's 156 nights per year, the two outreach buses are packed with hot meals, bag lunches, clothing, blankets, and other basic needs. Each bus is staffed by one or two employees and two to three volunteers. Both buses travel a specific route through Milwaukee County, one on the south and one on the north. And the routes stay as consistent as possible so people know where and when to find the Street Angels. There is an average of 35 to 40 stops per route. And some of these stops include homeless encampments, beneath bridges, park and ride lots, and public meeting spots. Connections are made, basic needs are met, trust is gained, and a partnership with the individual is formed to assist them in developing strategies to obtain shelter, housing, treatment, and other vital services. Depending on the season, anywhere from 100 to 275 people are assisted each night that they go out. Since July of 2018, Street Angels has encountered 2,066 individuals verified to be experiencing unsheltered homelessness. Of these individuals, 100% of them were referred to partnering servicing agencies and 488 connected to permanent housing resources. This is just the briefest of overviews of the mission and the work of the Street Angels. Two of the founding members will be here tomorrow morning to explain it. And if you're able to come back, you might want to try to do that. I'm sure you'd enjoy. It was very interesting when we heard the presentation. The Street Angels have provided a short video about their work, and we will show it to you now.
Empty bottles, a cardboard box, these shattered dreams, this littered street, this broken block is heavy on your heart. But one thing is clear, you want to save the world, you ought to start here. You've come a long way, yeah, you've been blessed such a long way. Now go the rest. The tattered wings of stubborn angels, bad bet, full of regret, a long shot. Yeah, you can talk the talk, and that's just fine. But now you need to walk the walk and maybe run a few stop signs. Because tattered wings of stubborn angels, some more. stubborn angels.
The song that you heard in the background of the video is entitled Stubborn Angels by Brad Paisley. Street angels are hope dealers, providing people who are experiencing unsheltered homelessness with basic supplies, emotional support, advocacy, resources, and guidance to a path that can help lead them to a place that they can call home. And I'll close with one more Bible verse. This is from Hebrews chapter 13. Keep on loving each other as brothers. Do not forget to entertain strangers, for by doing so, some people have entertained angels without knowing it. Amen.
Good song for that is, after that is, Blessed Are They. So let's try that.
Kingdom, shine for all to see. be glad. Blessed are you, holy are you, rejoice and be glad. Yours is the kingdom of God.
And we will have the offering now.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Because of what the Lord has done for us. And now say, I am rich because of what the Lord has done for us. Give thanks. Give thanks.
God of field and forest, sea and sky, you are the giver of all good things. Sustain us with these gifts of your creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Please join me in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Trusting in God's abundant mercy, let us offer our prayers for the world in need. You entice your church to speak truth that challenges false notions of peace. Prevail upon us with the good news of Christ's death and resurrection, that we are compelled to share the gospel with all the world. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Under your watch, not even a sparrow goes unnoticed. You safeguard plant and animal habitats through the earth's ever-changing climate of your own design. Guide us in your responsible stewardship of the earth's resources put in our care. God, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Our world is enduring violence and destruction. Rescue your people in nations experiencing conflict or crisis. We especially pray for the conflict in Ukraine and Eastern Europe. Thwart the efforts of those who sow chaos and terror, and guide those working to bring about peace and reconciliation. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You have counted even the hairs of our heads. Reassure anyone experiencing poverty, homelessness, unemployment, or exploitation that every life has value. Look favorably upon all who struggle. Answer us, for your steadfast love is good. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Even when we experience rejection, your love invites us to new life. Help us to understand we are all your people. Lift up anyone who feels shunned or excluded on account of their gender, race, national origin, or any other assumed human distinction. Let them know you do not make mistakes, and they are who you made them to be. Make your people one. We especially pray this evening for Dave T., Mark T., Jordan L., Andrew, Patrick C., and Jane, and the citizens of Ukraine and Eastern Europe, and for all those serving in the military around the globe, and those who have returned home. And any others you may want to pray out loud at this time or in your heart.
Carol, Wayne, Keith, Ruth, Shannon, Lois, Mark.
God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All who have died with Christ also live with him. We give thanks for all the saints whose faithful confessions inspired our own discipleship and raise us with them to eternal life. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive our prayers and answer us, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
With thanksgiving, we remember that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this. As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Let us join together in praying the prayer that the Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The table is set. All are welcome. Please come forward. Thank you.
listen to your children praying. Lord, send your spirit in this place. Lord, listen to your children praying. Send us love, send us power, send us grace.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep you in God's grace. Amen. I don't know, are there other announcements at this point? I know that we have things coming up, but some of them are farther along in the month. So we'll wait on those. Okay, and then again, thank everybody who helped with the St. Ben's meal. We all appreciate that and are so blessed that we have people that want to help with that.
That was a great time. There was a lot of great people there. And Randy knew some of the folks from his encounters down there already. So he was, hi, Mike, how you doing? So
that's true.
It was great to help those people out. And it was great for us to be there together.
It was. The one little child, I told you we had one child, he came in and he said, I'm 10. About three times. And then he's like, really? I'm 9. But I'm going to be 10. And I asked, I think it was his aunt, you know, when is his birthday? January. So he has a ways to go, but he was so cute. They were all cute. Okay.
And all the people said,
no. Oh, and we're going to have the song. It's a good song.
You are not alone if you are lonely when you feel afraid. You're not the only, we are all the same. In need of mercy, to be forgiven and be free. In all you've got to lean on, thank God it's all you need. In all the people said amen. Oh, 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 and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. If you're rich or poor, well, it don't matter. Weak or strong, you know, love is what we're after. Well, you're all broken, but we are all together. God knows we stumble and fall. And he so loved the world, he sent his son to love us all. And all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. Oh, 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 and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. Blessed are the poor in spirit, who torn apart. Blessed are the persecuted and the pure in heart. Blessed are the hungry people for another start. Theirs is the kingdom. The kingdom of God, and all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. said amen. Oh, 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 oh. And all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen.
Sharing God's love.
And all the people said amen. Oh, oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen.